huh? Helping a friend in need?
Come on, Chopper. Come on.
Oh, yeah. Taking out some hillbilly crank dealers on a blood feud. That's what I live for.
Hey, Trev, man, we gonna borrow this and head back to town.
Sure.
Come on, Michael, man. I'll drop your ass off on the way back. Chop, get in.
See you back at Castle Phillips, Mike.
Yeah, thanks for the warning.
wheelchair. Clarence and I fought in the war together, right on the front lines of the war on terror. We drove around at night and drove a cold road. We saw a foreigner acting swirly. We called 911. Right after we shot him,
this apex predator in action.
Many a time when I was down on both knees, giving a working girl the business, my mind would turn to you, and that you are crippled and can't enjoy the pleasures of the flesh.
No, I don't need a wheelchair because I got a motorized scooter now. The relaxed power hits from ambulance. Dude, I had that thing lowered, neon, custom paint job, overhaul the engine. You wouldn't believe the mad booty I've been getting lately. Besides, my doctor said I don't need a wheelchair or whatever, and that I could walk just fine. I'm just tired, Dwayne. You know how I do. I like to sit down, have a beer, masturbate, you know, relax.
Oh, that's wonderful news there, Clarence. I love hearing you're getting booty. Thanks for calling into the show, buddy. I love... Will, we received an electronic message in our inbox last week that says, Dwayne, you are so
drunk. Whoa!
I was wondering if you've been watching.
Damn it all. You ain't too smart, are you?
Now, by the melodic and poignant music playing in the background, I am about to unleash a barrage of emotion that has been trapped inside of me for these past 20 years. We attended Central High School together, and I sat behind you in science class. And on days where there was a football game, you wore your cheerleader. To this very day, I nearly break out in tears that I have not told you of the thunderous lust you arouse in me. Now, I would not break out in tears for real, as a man's tears are saved in a special place for when his favorite stock car driver loses. But know this, I, as often as this week, have kept you in regular rotation in the Dwayne Earl Spank Bank. I fantasize about you turn around in science class and asking if we can get together to study for the test, and you'd arrive at my domicile. I'd show you around, offer you a cigarette I'd stolen from my stepfather. And in the backyard, I performed feats of greatness, exhibiting my skills at archery, knife throwing, and camouflage face painting in particular. We'd have a fireworks war with Roman candles, then ride fast on a dirt bike by the stream. You'd have your arms around me.
Oh, shit!
And you'd fall off the back and break your leg, and I'd console you. We'd make passionate love in a cloud of exhaust by the dirt bike still running. Our youthful giddiness accentuated by the intoxicating. Before I began to lose my hair. However, know this, Marty. I still have a ponytail, and it is one of my most attractive features, especially when I wear a baseball cap.
You should come by for some pie so we can catch up.
I would very much like to embark on this Epicurean endeavor.
You know, Tracy Bish, she used to talk about you.
Tracy Bish is goddamn lying. Any performance issues, it is because my third brain could predict the future, and it knew...
can have. I like having five wives, you know? I mean, sometimes they gang up on me and wrestle me, tie me down.
Ah, look at that. You gotta love rural America.
Something that I partake in on a regular basis, often after a bowling night when the ladies are all lubed up. But you polygamy guys, well, because every time you see pictures or footage, the women, they're always so frumpy. Get two hot chicks, not five chubby hairy ones, and they wear those terrible old lady dresses that cover up the important bits. On my farm, we have a bunch of women, and they work with nothing but a bikini and a gun belt on.
What?
Ah!
Oh, damn, man!
Good Lord.
What the?
We did it! Lester the molester, bro! We got ourselves some military hardware. It's parked out back in my office.
All right. We might be ready to move on this thing. Meet me up in the lab.
It's not inappropriate. It's
another one of your fucking disasters. That's what it is. First you take a hostage against my advice, and then you start some kind of crazy high school romance with her? Are you nuts?
She's
a 60-year-old housewife.
Wow, she's 57. And she thinks that I'm mature.
Yeah, well, let me tell you something. 30 years of marriage to the world's angriest mob boss would make anyone insane. You're not making my situation any easier.
Oh, there's a surprise. I knew it would become about you.
I miss my family.
Oh, you're full of shit. All you ever did was ignore them. And now that they're gone, you miss them. Fucking incredible.
I'll tell you what's incredible. Fucking incredible.
Hey.
You mother...
Hey!
What?
Enough! You got me out here. You wrote me into your crazy world of bullshit. If it was lies, new age shit, and arguments about how good life used to be, I could have stayed my ass in Los Santos.
Hello, Franklin.
What's up?
All right. Here's the shot. We're going to Paleto Bay, and we're going to do this thing. Any questions? Comments?
Yeah. I miss Brad. That crazy motherfucker was with us now. He would have loved this. Instead, he's got to enjoy himself molesting white-collar criminals in a federal penitentiary.
Thanks for sharing. Anybody else?
What about me?
You'll be waiting for them by the river, handling the getaway.
All right.
Now, these three go in. They grab the take. They rendezvous with you, and you get out of there. Is that a work for everyone? Great. Let's go.
Let's get this done. Paleto Bay.
Welcome, Miss Biles Carmichael.
Yes, thank you, and you're welcome. So
you ever hit a bank before, Franklin?
Yeah, I was the driver on the job my boy Lamar pulled. Guess it's the same kind of shit we're doing now, right?
Nice, bro.
No.
What was the take?
Shit, I don't know, man. I can't remember.
Come on. Everyone remembers their first score.
Shit, not me.
Mikey, bro, what was your first bank score?
88, outskirts of Carcer City. Took a small franchise for 10G. Yeah, things were easier back then.
Yeah, 25 years ago. Jesus! Jeff, will you tell these gentlemen about your first job?
T, man. You could just as easily.
You tell them. I'll do a sanity check.
Trevor, the ultimate judge of sanity.
Well, it was part of the interview process, I guess is how you'd call it. Trevor knew I could cook, wanted to see if I could handle myself. This cash for gold guy comes through town. Stood to reason he had funds. Next thing we're burying him and his bodyguard in the junkyard. Well, most of them anyhow.
50K. He did fine. He's better at all aspects of the job now, from killing to dismemberment. Hey, your turn to share, kid.
I told you I don't remember the details, man.
Leave him alone, Trevor.
This is an important moment, Michael. Here we are, on our way to almost certain death, bonding, pouring our hearts out, and this guy is sitting here, soaking it up and giving nothing in return.
Hey, if he don't remember...
If he don't remember, I'm supposed to trust this man with my life, and he don't trust me with the details of his first bank job.
Well, how about you? Why don't you share with the group? I'm here, I'll back the facts.
The checks cash place?